I'm State Representative Mary Jo Daley, and I'm here to talk a little bit about gluten and just how important labeling is for people with celiac disease and other intolerances. House Bills 2122 and 2120 simply help people identify products that contain gluten. One piece of legislation would cover food labeling. That would be House Bill 2122. And the other one, House Bill 2120, would cover medicine labeling. Currently, under federal law, only food products containing wheat must be labeled to identify its presence. However, gluten can be found in grains other than wheat, including barley, oats, and rye. So without properly labeling all products that contain gluten, we are placing many of our fellow citizens at risk of developing severe reactions to the food and medicine they ingest. Many of us already know about celiac disease. Specifically, it's an illness caused by an autoimmune reaction to gluten, and it affects about 1% of the United States population alone. What many people don't know, however, is that another 6% of the population are estimated to have an intolerance to gluten as well, meaning that over 900,000 Pennsylvanians suffer from symptoms such as hives, skin rash, nausea, indigestion, vomiting, diarrhea, and joint pain when they ingest gluten. Some fare even worse, suffering from infertility, early osteoporosis, and low blood counts. These are the people who we are looking to protect with our very simple actions. Under the bills, clearly marked labels specify the existence of gluten in the product, include a statement detailing that food products containing gluten cause adverse health effects for people with celiac disease, food sensitivities, and other intolerances. Also, under the legislation, labels for gluten-free foods would only be allowed to specify that a product is gluten-free if the product does not contain gluten or an ingredient derived from a gluten-containing grain, and if the food product contains less than 20 parts per million of gluten. For medicine, the law would apply to oral controlled substances and other oral drugs derived from a gluten-containing grain, unless their label already bears a statement that the drug contains gluten and identifies the type of grain from which it's derived. Simply put, these labels would prevent accidental ingestion of gluten, protecting hundreds of thousands of Pennsylvanians from severe outcomes. They might seem like a small ask, but labels mean the world to a consumer trying to make an informed decision about the food and medicine they choose. I'd also like to thank my colleagues for their support in these life-saving measures, and for those of us fortunate enough to not have an intolerance to gluten. I challenge you to think of those who do and just how common sense labeling can be. Labeling also fosters trust and confidence among consumers. When people can easily identify which products meet their needs, it reduces the anxiety and uncertainty associated with shopping and meal planning. This empowerment is not only beneficial for those with gluten-related disorders, but also for their families and friends who share in their needs. From a broader perspective, labeling gluten-free foods also promotes inclusivity and awareness. It encourages the food industry to innovate and expand their product offerings, making it easier for everyone to find delicious and safe gluten-free options. This progress reflects our commitment to accommodating the diverse dietary needs of our community. In conclusion, the importance of labeling gluten-free foods cannot be overstated. It safeguards health, builds trust, and fosters a more inclusive society. Let's continue to advocate for clear, accurate, and accessible labeling, ensuring that everyone can make informed choices about the foods they consume.